Hello everyone and welcome back, and I'm needing to move my camera to the corner. Welcome back, I'm the James with the Games, and welcome back to being part of the missing members. And welcome to Journey to the Savage Planet. I've actually owned this game for a number of years, and I've never loaded it up. Not once. And there we go, that should work now. And I simply put, I've never played this. I also will not do old game minus, because if that looks a little bit too difficult. But I remember seeing a bunch of people play this quite some time ago, and I thought this looked really cool. I waited for it to go on sale, and because of it current, I don't want to play a game without Let's playing it. I should have said that this is a blind playthrough.
My name is Martin Tweed, President and CEO of Kindred Aerospace. Thank you for joining the Pioneer Program. For almost 30 years, Kindred has been striving to help humanity expand beyond the confines of Earth. And I am excited to announce that many industry observers now consider us the fourth best interstellar exploration company. From our humble beginnings, manufacturing batteries and solar arrays for use in extreme climates, to our line of athletic footwear and chic survival apparel, we have been continually striving to drive humanity further from the bottom of the oceans and now to the stars! Our next step is to move beyond pure exploration and into settlement, which is why you are here. Our scientists have identified several planets that may be fit for human habitation. Yours is...
ERY-26.
Your job is to explore the planet's surface, catalog its creatures, threats, and opportunities, and...
Yeah.
Objectives for you and your partner, if you have one. I should also mention that while every effort has been made to ensure a comfortable and safe journey, recent budget challenges plus the unknown natures of the obstacles you will face mean that we were unable to send you anything in the way of equipment. But don't stress, however, as your habitat comes equipped with a 3D printer that's more than capable of turning any old space trash you discover into useful items. One minor note. All the fuel in your javelin was used in the journey from Earth and the landing on your planet. You will need to discover a local resource that you can refine into an appropriate fuel. Unless, of course, you decide to spend the rest of your life off Earth. But I don't want to take up too much of your time, and I'm sure you're very excited to explore. So I wish you good luck. We will send updates on your progress as you complete your scheduled surveys. Stay alive, and see you soon.
Okay.
Welcome. My name is Echo, and I'm here to help guide you on your mission. But first things first, please log into the computer and fill out a teeny-weeny questionnaire, if you don't mind, so we can make sure you're not crazy.
All right. Kindred Technologies. Also, me messing around, that was partially because of the fact that I oddly have my PS3 controller plugged into my PC right now. This is because of during the last game I played, it would not go ahead and read my... this controller, if I can grab it, because of it's underneath my headphones. It wouldn't read this controller. And so, this controller, which has been plugged into my PS3 all this time, I decided to see if it'd accept it. And it does. But for some reason, just like on that controller, on this controller, I cannot get the camera to go left. I don't know why. It looks like you made it. Good job. As per your Kindred Employee Experience Program benefits contract, you're contractually obligated to submit regular reports during your mission. Let's begin.
One of my jobs is to continually assess your mental state, and as space sickness has been an issue for some other recent explorers, could you please identify yourself from this gallery of faces?
Oh my goodness, these are so funny. Probably the one that looks crazy. Because of that, that's probably me. Because of, I'm allergic to dogs. No, I am not a dog.
Thank you. I'm super glad you're not crazy.
Thank you for your time, Explorer J75X321. This is the end of the report. Please press the submit button to... What? From Kindred Aerospace. Greetings, Explorer Name here. Welcome to your first day of your great adventure. We cannot be more excited to welcome you to Planet Name here. As a key member of Kindred's quest to explore the stars, it is imperative that brave people such as yourself turn over every rock, scan every blade of grass, and dig the precious crafting ingredients from the innards of every beast you encounter so that our database may grow and humanity may continue to expand across the infinite reaches of space. Humanity has been trapped on Earth for the entirety of its existence. We can be bigger. We can be more. Help us get there. Sincerely yours, Martin Tweed, founder and CEO.
Hi, my name is Martin Tweed, president and CEO of Kindred Aerospace. Thank you for joining the Pioneer Program. For almost 30 years, Kindred has been striving to help humanity expand beyond the confines of Earth. And I am excited to announce that many industry observers now consider us the fourth best interstellar exploration.
Oh, this is literally just the same thing again.
From our humble beginnings, manufacturing batteries and solar arrays for use in extreme climates, to our line of athletic footwear and chic survival apparel, we have been continually striving to drive humanity further from the bottom of the oceans and now to the stars. Our next step is to move beyond pure exploration and into settlement, which is why you are here. Our scientists have identified several planets that may be fit for human habitation. Yours is
ARY-26.
Your job is to explore the planet's surface, log its creatures, threats, and opportunities, and send your data back to our crack team of scientists here at Kindred for analysis. The more you discover, the more we'll be able to guide your experience and highlight objectives for you and your partner, if you have one. I should also mention that while every effort has been made to ensure a comfortable and safe journey, recent budget challenges plus the unknown natures of the obstacles you will face mean that we were unable to send you anything in the way of equipment. But don't stress, however, as your habitat comes equipped with a 3D printer that is more than capable of turning any old space trash you discover into useful items. One minor note. All the fuel in your javelin was used in the journey from Earth and the landing on your planet. You will need to discover a local resource that you can refine into an appropriate fuel. Unless, of course, you decide to spend the rest of your life off Earth. But I don't want to take up too much of your time, and I'm sure you're very excited to explore. So I wish you good luck. We will send updates on your progress as you complete your scheduled surveys. Stay alive, and see you soon.
This is interesting, because of...
Long-term space travel is not for everyone. Side effects from long-term space travel are uncommon, but...
when you think about it...
Chest pain, varicose veins, bloody stools, feeling of emptiness or hopelessness, osteoarthritis, hemorrhoid, diabetes, forgetfulness, gender confusion, spontaneous dental prolapse, mild discomfort, or death. If you know
this is being... most likely... our character was put into cryo sleep for this. So,
And now you're ready to explore. Please walk downstairs and step into the teleporter while I will discombobulate you and then recombine you outside on this glorious new planet.
So, most likely, it has been several years, if not decades. Options, controls. I'm trying to figure out which button's which. Oh, geez. There's only two controller methods. Yeah. Because of up is up, down is up. Right is down. I have a feeling that this isn't due to the actual controller itself, but it's actually due to my computer misreading the inputs from my hub here. Because of... that in and of itself should not, because of, is this the right controller? Let's try something. Let's try plugging this directly into my PC. No, it still does the exact same thing because of this. Oh, this isn't even going ahead and registering. Despite the fact this is also somehow plugged in. I have so many cords tangled down here. Because if that's left, that's right, that's down. But on this one, oh, it only accepts the first controller that was put in. Okay, that kind of makes sense. This is going to be really weird because this is tank. This is... okay. Come on, go up. Thank you. Now we need to go. Okay, let's turn left. And I'm going to get this mixed up because of, I'm so used to PlayStation controls, and the default setup for button symbols is Xbox.
Welcome to ARY-26. It doesn't seem to be, well, a planet at all, really. More detonation of rocks. This mission just got 100% more interesting and about 50% more lethal.
Come on.
Exploration, the Javelin is equipped with several small robotic drones that can perform basic scans of the world around you. Please launch them by opening the exterior hatch.
This is gonna drive me nuts. I'm like, I would love it if someone knew of a place to get controllers that were guaranteed to work. Oh, pardon me a moment. All right, sorry about that. Okay, this one definitely has a harder to control camera than this one does. Like, I'm pretty sure I own like 5 controllers in all of them, and I mean all of them, the right stick does not work correctly on it. And I don't know why. I'm like, let me see here. Where's the other one? I have this one. That also has like an exceptionally short, table on it. Oh, this one, it doesn't. This one, the computer does not even recognize this as a controller. It does not recognize this as a controller. Nope, nothing works on it. Wait, can I actually go ahead and use the actual controller for movement in this? Gah. And yes, I can. Okay, I can actually deal with this. Here it is. Bam!
Great. Now they'll provide you with approximate locations of resources and important info.
All right.
That one's pretty banged up, but you'll need to scan the exterior to confirm the level of bang-upness. Do that now. Don't forget to continually scan your surroundings. The camera will transmit data back to Kindred HQ, which will send you blueprints for stuff. Then you can collect stuff to make the stuff in the blueprints, and that stuff will help you survive against the stuff you took pictures of. This exterior panel must have been knocked loose on landing. I am adding a location marker to your compass. Please find it and scan it. If you lose your way, you can always hit the survey button to highlight its location again. Fuel tanks are intact, but empty. If you can find a local fuel source, you'll be able to get back home. If you can't, congratulations, you're home already. That's not supposed to look like that.
Not the smoothest landing, but at least we survived, right?
This machine will copy you into its memory, delete your body, and then print a copy of it 5 feet away.
Spencer's unlimited bait become the master of bait. Oh. Problem scan, 3 out of 3. Missing panel scan, 1 out of 3.
Whenever you need help finding your currently selected objective, you can use survey to orient yourself. The javelin is basically intact, but in need of minor repairs. If we ever want to relaunch. Oh, the cartographers found an alien alloy we could maybe use to repair the ship. Let me mark it.
Okay. At the very least, this is doable with this setup because of... Because of, I've had some games in which you can only use either keyboard and mouse or controllers.
I am detecting a fortuitously fragile surface nearby. Please scan to confirm. These crystals look extremely breakable. You could take out some unexamined aggression on them. So... looks like you will need a new tool in order to venture further. I have added a new blueprint to the Javelin's 3D printer that should do the trick. But in order to print it, you'll need to gather some basic resources from the local fauna. Aww, it's chilly. Birds may not look it, but they're salty as hell. They're drugs, but good drugs. For healing, not fun.
That most stuff is made of.
Hey, look at that. You picked up some carbon. Good for you. Nice work. You have collected an enough carbon to craft a basic Nomad plasma pistol. The 3D printer inside the Javelin is ready for your input.
Oy, oy, oy.
I won't lie. I feel kind of bad. They're so cute.
Scan.
These aren't reeds.
Not tentoweeds, tentoreeds. Big difference. They can also be used to bait creatures around.
Grog, the only food in this universe that tastes exactly like it sounds.
I take it you can't actually parkour all the way up these cliffs out here. The what is that? They could wind up over there at some point. But the other reason that I really decided to play this game in particular is that
every time you return to the Javelin, you automatically deposit any resources you were carrying. Anything you drop outside the Javelin, however, will stay there until you go and grab it with your meat hands.
With exemplary convenience, with tastes, flavors, and textures like beef, chicken, corn, chocolate mousse, hard candy, chili bacon burger, sunny man, and chives, baked ziti, chocolate swirl, Long John Donuts, Salisbury steak, pasta paisano, buffalo banana wings, horse biscuits, pineapple pizza poppers, lamb's flea, poutine, wonton, people surprise, cucumber shit water, nose broth, and literally trillions more.
Now that's good flavor.
Broth, the 100% artificial food replacement gel taking Earth by storm. Don't be a snob. Eat with the mob. Replace your food with Grog.
Grog is considered a plus 9 pressure cluster and is not cleared for non-terrestrial territory, which cannot under any circumstances be to star dribbles. See website for details.
The disclosures, man. The disclosures. Ex-serve succulent meal. Oh. Oh, okay, inventory full. Sours, the sours are...
Meat scraps, fat, and gristle finding its way to your trash? What a waste! Or even worse, the toilet? Disgusting! Put a smile on your face using your meat waste with Meat Buddy, the reconstituted companion from Slimo. Just take your animal-based waste products, rotten flesh, and laboratory-thrown proteins, and simply toss in the hopper. Choose the number and type of appendages, and in just 4 short clychips, your new best friend will emerge, ready to cuddle. Meat Buddy, the snuggly playmate from Slimo.
Ew, that was disgusting.
Stroll, shop, and live as they autonomously move throughout their very own shopping complex, completely unaware of your presence. Engage in fascinating examination of standard Earth activity, or declare a Black Friday. Extend your shoppers into a violent bargain hunting frenzy where only the shoppers. Name all Live Shopping Mall Biochamber. 3 packets of powdered micro monkeys and stirring stick from Lil Labs.
Oh my goodness, this is so dumb. We've already seen that. Okay. Ten carbon to make a nomad pistol. Now you've got a weapon, the single
tool for any colonizer.
Need 100 carbon for that, 100 silicon. 100 silicon and 100 carbon. Fired element undiscovered. Not live sampler. Allows you to extract a live sample from living tissue. Not required on current mission. Fired element undiscovered. Oh, General doesn't actually. I really hate that it shows LB and RB when those to me refer to L1 and R2, L1 and R1, and they mean L2 and R2, which royally messes with my head. Temperate foresty and active volcanoes. All in one area. Hello again, an explorer name here. Congratulations on the tremendous progress you made on planet name. Well, I'm sure by now the isolating loneliness of space exploration has started to set in. Rest assured that your personal sacrifice has not gone unnoticed. Martin Tweed, Kindred's fearless and intrepid CEO, was distinctly heard remarking that he was interested in the one-paragraph summary he skimmed documenting our 74 active pioneers' hard work. Well done! Oh my goodness. As you continue to pursue your goal of exploring and documenting your exciting new planet, be sure to maintain a keen awareness of the Kindred value system. Leave no stone unturned. If a stone refuses to turn, smash it to pieces. Explore every nook and cranny. Should a cranny or nook seem too dangerous, get in there and check it out anyways. That's why we pay you. Take pride in your work and defend Kindred property at all costs. Advanced space tech is expensive and hard to manufacture. Printing new limbs and extremities can be done at a fraction of the cost. And four, have fun. That was funny. All right, guess we have to head out now.
Ambient temperature 112 degrees, biosigns nominal.
This is snow! How is the ambient temperature 112? And also, no, it's not like I'm moving slowly. This is literally your standard walking speed for some reason. An inconveniently placed crystalline barrier could be destroyed with enough force. I'm trying to make sure I don't miss anything. Oh, I have a feeling I know what that starting thing determined. It determined what your character sounded like. Once. Polypod tree, a wildly branching rosy fungusoid. The tip of each branch.
It may sound weird, but do you see a large tower moving above you? I only ask because my system appears to be functioning correctly, but our initial scan said there should be no sign of intelligent life here at all. Directly contradict this idea. I will contact your superiors immediately. One moment, please.
New feature, snap targeting. You can now lock onto targets looking at by holding down L.
Urgent message regarding the tower from our president and CEO, which is available for your viewing pleasure at the habitat. Please return as soon as you have a moment. Now that's metal.
Bag spun from a wiry metallic thread filled with carefully preserved seeds. Okay.
Edible and slightly hallucinogenic. As with all edibles, take it slow. These unhatched alien eggs can be used like a natural trampoline. Ethically iffy, yes. Effective? You bet.
Oh, that isn't something to scan. Okay. Sanctar's frigid embrace. Okay, that was funny.
Hey, buddy. So, you died, and I made a clone of you that shares your memories. Listen, just don't overthink this. Our bioprinting is accurate to 99.1%. So, as long as you don't die 49 more times, it's all good.
Says there's still more.
These scraps, fat and gristle, finding its way to your trash? What a waste! even worse.
Oh, that's just the letter V.
The only thing is, your planet is, wrong. Not wrong. Strange. Unusual. We need to know what's inside that structure. Okay. How did our scanners miss it? Who built it? I need you to dig up everything you can. We are searching for a new home for humanity, after all. I need you to transmit this data directly to me, okay? I've already updated your transfer protocols. This needs to be our little secret for now.
Meat scraps, fat, and gristle finding its way to your trash? What?
Okay, here it is.
Hello. Is thing working? Sorry, buddy. Hey, yeah, you. Hi, I apologize for the one-sided nature of this message, but, you know, communication across vast distances makes it impossible to do anything else. So, I hear you've arrived on ARY-26, and I've seen some of the preliminary data, and I have to tell you, we have a few questions. Well, as you know, every planet we initially surveyed showed no sign of intelligent life. The only thing is, your planet is, wrong. Not wrong. Strange. Unusual. We need to know what's inside that structure. Okay. How did our scanners miss it? Who built it? I need you to dig up everything you can. We are searching for a new home for humanity, after all. I need you to transmit this data directly to me. Okay. I've already updated your transfer protocols. This needs to be our little secret for now.
All right. Interesting enough. I still can't believe I'm having to use both the controller and the mouse in order to control this. Like,
temperature 81 degrees. Biosigns nominal.
Oh, I need to jump. Recharge. Oh, I guess I was not going fast enough to make that jump. Okay. Well, that didn't work. Hope. Okay, I have a feeling that I did not do that properly at all. But it looks like there's something over on that right area. That area that we just passed up, but I don't know how we get to it. There we go. Ah, oh, okay. Ah, all right. Resource pack. Oh, the last guy died and dropped his stuff. Now it's your stuff. Enjoy. Cover resources. I do love it. The ability to scan things and ooh, what is that?
I'm detecting a nearby organic compound which may be useful on our exploration efforts.
Carbon vein. That's okay.
With your oxygen supply may allow me to tweak its impact on your biology, which would in turn allow you to be more attuned to the local climate. Long-term impacts are unknown, but ingestion is, of course, completely your decision. Please remain calm. I am monitoring your physical response. All is as predicted. I am adjusting your health and biofeedback to reflect your improved suitability to the chemical mix. I salute your continued embrace of adventure. This door seems to respond to your energy signature. A big electric jolt should disable its mechanism for a while. I'll update your compass if the cartographers find anything to do just that. That upgrade would be very useful indeed. I have sent a request to Kindred, but we have yet to locate the required resources on this planet. Stay tuned.
Restock. Jelly waft basin. I'm pretty sure. Nope.
Exactly like a normal squid, except for its aerial properties and size and everything about it.
Okay. Okay. Silicon. Oh, wait, there's one back here. I missed all the orange goose. Oh, there it is. Huzzah! All right, that's 48 silicon. Which allows us to walk on up here. Level up.
So, good news, bad news. Good news is those things you ate made you way harder to kill. Bad news is you're harder to kill because most of your bones have been replaced with rock-hard space tumors. Good news. Potential partners dig tumors, or so I hear.
Nope, that cannot be scanned. Look at this beautiful area that's just over this way. Ooh, look, a carbon deposit. Ew. Oh, that it does legit nothing. More carbon. The flowers are not scannable. Good to know. Holding the stupid bouncy item actually kind of visually like screws me up because of and this is our fourth orange goo already. Oh, this is like an actual water flow. Nope, that doesn't result in anything.
Ah, a natural spa. How tranquil.
Nothing like the one from Dante's Peak. Let's do some parkour to get up here. Unless this literally does nothing for us, which I have a sneaking suspicion it might. There's no more, like, easy to reach. Down to the ground we go. Okay. Oh. $239 carbon. Not half bad. This is the way we came in. No, it just looks like that's something important, but it's not. Wait, pink. These actually important. No. Nope, these are just set pieces. Because somehow, of course they are. There's a vitality place. There's an entire area that's like up there that we can't reach yet. Because of, spoiler alert, it looks like we're going to get a grappling hook at some point. That did nothing. Did I see something that was like up here? Does not appear to be. Seriously. All that does is cause it to spurt out more goop. Doesn't really look like there's anything we can do from here. What am I doing? Why am I trying to use the axles? Right stick here. Of course that occurs. But there's like nothing to actually land on. That it'd actually be useful for this right now is the problem. Oh, look! It exploded! That might actually be everything we can get in this area. I've yet to really use the bait, comically enough. Oh, wait. Can I just use this right here? Yes. Yes, I can. I'm an idiot. Wow, I completely overthought how to get up here at the very least. We're blowing your... Ah! Down we go. Wow, that is really incredibly disorienting. Come on. Thank you. All right, now I can get a sense of my bearings again. Like, oy, 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 that's so disorienting. Aha, and there's one right over here. Fresh. Oh, there's a little pathway down here.
Nature's little hoarder.
A living loop vault. To crack it open, investigate the nearby area for clues. Got him. Might as well call it Upgradium!
Amazing! You found a different nugget of the alloy we've been searching for. This should still allow me to perform the necessary repairs, and I salute your proclivity for self-direction.
Problem is, there's something up there, and I'm like... I'm going to fathom to guess we can't reach it yet because we don't have, like, the proper jump upgrades or something. Oh my goodness, I really wish this area wasn't so white. Oh. We could literally jump off the map if we wanted. Oh no, oh no, I am literally stuck. Oh no, I am stuck. I should not have come over here. Oh no, I didn't mean to do that. Whoops. Whoopsie doodles. Oh, this game was released in 2020. That's actually not that old compared to my typical, game. Oh, there it goes. Allows you to carry and hold shock fruits. Oh. Oh, please tell me they don't have it recorded that I died in the actual pit.
112 degrees, biosigns, nominal.
Please do not tell me they have me dying in the pit. And also, this makes me question if... Nope, it does not look like... Well, that missed. Okay, so... Oh, boy! Nope, that was not far enough. I hope I didn't just accidentally softlock the game by doing that. Nope. Jumped clean off of it without even hitting it. Hallelujah! We did it! Ay, ay, ay. Wait, it says it's that direction. Okay, I am not going to question it, game. Now. Did I just hear, yeah? That sounded like a sound effect from Donkey Kong. Darn it. Nope. Dang it. Ow, indeed. I'm like, why can't I move? Hallelujah. Thank you. Come down here. Oh no. It's in the pit. It's legitimately in the pit. Ugh. What's worse is that since I only have one bouncy ammo left, I have to go down here. I have to find one of these things. I have to shoot it from the ceiling. Wait, what? Oh, okay. It wasn't in the pit. That was surprisingly lucky. I thought for sure that it would be in the pit again. I thought for absolute sure. Good to hear. Man alive, we move so slowly. Is there actually... I was moving faster for a second there. Okay, that did marginally better. Is it supposed to be this finicky? Change, throw. No. Mm. Well, that didn't do what I wanted it to at all. It's funny because this game does not have like a... tutorial for sprinting. And it feels like you're supposed to naturally be able to sprint. Oh. All right.
You can craft an upgrade if you wanna.
Okay, leave. Ready to craft. Improve damage. Finding Uncle Fauna too tough? Add some punch to your shots with this upgrade.
Upgrade complete.
One alien alloy. You need 25 more silicon for that. More alien alloys. Aluminum! Your zoom distance and improves the survey range? Alright, time to head back out.
Obstacles you will face, but the more data you provide to Kindred through your scanning tools, the more appropriate blueprints we'll be able to send you. On behalf of everyone at Kindred, both biological and autonomous, we wish you good luck.
Oh, it's Elf!
We identified a series of very unusual structures at the core of this planet. While our earlier data indicated a rogue planet, this now appears to be incorrect. This is a radical mission-altering discovery, and while you must continue to catalog the planet, Kindred requests that you pay extra attention to anything that appears unnatural or constructed. I have placed a marker at a point of particular interest to our scientists.
Grapple target up there. Oh, look, these things are back to being alive again. More silicon. Here discovered the verdant wilds of Zill. Canopy leaf. So leafy, so luscious, so luxurious. This, I do love how this game's done in a way that it actually makes you feel like you're exploring an alien planet, though it's kind of weird because of
this anthill is way bigger than the ones on Earth, but the ants are the same size.
I just heard something screaming.
These aren't weeds.
Tentacle is part of a much larger, thirstier creature living deep underground. What? Where? Oh look, another carbon deposit. It's not like we have too much, not enough carbon at this point. 50. Oh!
Like a normal puffer bird, but wrinkly.
Not weeds, reeds. Big difference. Hey! Another level up.
Okay, so even more good news. Those tumors that improved your stamina and replaced your bones, they've spread to the musculature of your lower body, which gives you rock-hard glutes. You should be psyched.
Wait. That what I think it is? Gotcha. Victor creature doesn't represent anything we've seen on the planet so far.
Chim-chiminy.
That's a dumb and old reference to make. Oh. Hello, Sutton! Grave Store. Wait. Oh no, I just saw this thing. I'm like, what did I just see?
It's a vein of pure aluminum.
Ooh. That'd be helpful if I could reach it.
A cracked wall. I have a few theories on what is possible here. All of them involve explosives. That upgrade would be very useful indeed. I have sent a request to Kindred, but we have yet to locate the required resources on this planet. Stay tuned. Rectangular prisms. Whee!
Okay. I am loving an AI companion can be very hit or miss, but like, they're doing it so well here. Oh, we can't even jump on that. Okay. Well, that was pointless. There's a grapple plant. Feeling that grapple plant will do something that we are not gonna expect it to. Oh. Hello, yet another one. I see one flying this way. I'm going to scan everything I can. I love the little flavor text. I thought I saw something. Towering Crystals of Madness.
You're gonna have to climb that crystal formation. If you had a grapple, it'd be a piece of piss. My vocabulary database got scrambled in the, I meant cake. It'd be a piece of cake. I don't get it. This planet was supposed to be devoid of intelligent life, but these structures... Why don't you scan this one? Looks like some sort of transport device. If you turn it back on, we can kill you here and make a clone of you at another one you've activated. Or, sorry... I'm supposed to say teleport. Before you jump in, Kindred says I need to read you a 400-page waiver absolving them of all responsibility. I speed read it.
Oh, finally. I can restock on these. This wall does not look right. This wall's off color from everything around it. Scanning.
These are like glow shrubs, but lazier.
Glowy flowers, unless apart, useless, apart from said glowiness. Wait, dagummit, you have a giant blue glowing crystal and I can't get anything from it. sickly, but still loves you. More carbon! Okay, and that's just another wrap around. Go head down. I don't know why, but I think maybe.
Glowy, but maybe useful too.
Group of bioluminescent pods might work as a makeshift flashlight. Oh, neat. Neat. What? What? Huh? Hey, look, another one. Grab. Ah, so that's how you get a new one. Precarious Shrine.
This may be the first ever chronicled example of alien art.
What's going on? We don't really need that anymore, and oh, hey, we got another jackpot one. One more carbon. Crouch under here. Ooh. 50 aluminum. That's our very first aluminum we've gotten. Wow.
Good work. Now you have the required resources to print a brand new jump pack at the habitat. While untested and not necessarily safe, it is guaranteed to be amusing.
Okay, then. What's weird is that you don't have, like, an actual map. So, Honestly, I don't know. I understand the compass at the top, but like... Oh, great. Hey, 100 aluminum. Oh, there's one over here. No, no. Oy, oy, oy. The camera in this game has to be my worst enemy. I'm getting better at it, though. All right. What is... Oh, I'm guessing those... Ew, wow.
Good news. Kidd is happy with your work so far, and they've decided to reward you with more work. Because capitalism. They've sent along some experiments, which you can tackle at your leisure. They've also added a brand new live sample tool to your 3D printer at no extra cost. Who says Kindred doesn't love you?
Meat scraps, fat, and gristle finding its way to your trash? What a way!
Backpack. Jump, jump, jump.
I see you have upgraded your jetpack. While not capable of full flight yet, it should still allow you to access previously unreachable locations with only minimal release of atmospheric pollutants.
All right. Oh, for science!
Amazing. Remember, completing your new science experiments will increase your rank, and increasing your rank will unlock all kinds of new tools. Hurrah for progress!
Never lose any loot again! Momentum discovered. Need more silicon and need an alien alloy. Need an alien alloy. Proof damage 2. Experiments completed. Scan 25% of Kindex. We've gotten that done. Weatherboard, but what? Wow, we've only found one of these three things. Kill four creatures with a single Alpha Puffer Bird detonation. Ooh. To trigger the boost at the very last moment, so don't die. Some of the smaller creatures may. Investigate tower, you'll need. Alright. That was weird. I didn't think it'd do that bit again until I re. Actually, no. No, honestly, I don't know why it did that.
Ambient temperature 92 degrees. Vital signs nominal.
Oh my goodness, how the world would you get over there? Oh, because of it, that was a silicon creature. Low silicon vein. Stupid deck on camera. Wait, did it despawn right as I got to it? Oh, hey. Another alien eligible. Another orange goo. Yay. Ouch. Hey, gum. Trying to get a sample from one of those is going to be an absolute mess.
citrus fruit favored by the frugivores of this planet.
Bufferboard complete. We've already gotten that. Whack this, so that way we can restore our health. Who are these creatures? I hope this statue is not to scale. What is with some of the noises? I also find it interesting how this planet is like biomes just like seemingly randomly connected together. Like, there doesn't seem to be any.
It thinks you're gonna kill it. Aw.
I still don't know how you're supposed to get the ones that are from things that are upside down. Oh, that's a grapple flower. Where's that noise coming from? Is it coming from up there? It might be. There's like nothing out here. Where am I going? Where I come from, where I go, where I come from, Cat Nigel. Imagine the indignity of dying to a giant falling tomato! Kane's Icy Refuge. That didn't help. Head down this path? Why are these even in here? Another 50 silicon? Level up! Okay, so apparently we don't have to, like, stand and eat it. If it's on the freaking ceiling, we can just grab it. That's good to know. I was like, do we need an upgrade to get those things? No, we don't, apparently. Which way did we even come from? Oh, that was just a texture thing from my shot. Okay. Jump over. Crouch down. Scanning.
Looks important. You should break it.
It's immaculate alien vessel's ornate design represents blah blah blah. Chest good. Open now. Can't get up there. Okay. Oh, wait, I get it. Gotcha. Do we not have the tools to do this yet? I would have thought we did. That's the way we came in, so. Oh. Must mean something. Tindex updated. Alien glitch. What? Martin Tweed, Bolster's Press and billions of dollars richer than you. Martin Tweed, CEO of Kindred Corporation, is a privileged sack of air, rephrasing, money-hoarding faux philanthropist who, air, rephrasing, decent guy, rephrasing, inspiring entrepreneur, rephrasing, who wants to be and or be with, and he earns his billions ethically, and the life extension therapies he's undergone haven't at all turned him into a centuries-old decrepit bag of meat, barely contained within a tightly stretched skin sack, lacking all interest in anything other than the ruthless pursuit of profit, and he's good at doing it. Ah. That actually do? Yes, it was scanning it. Oy, oy, oy. Scan to the left. That's 2 of 3. Now, where in the world is the third one? Carbon! Yay! Silicon. Oh, right. Got it. Hey, another alien alloy. Oh, that was actually pretty awesome. No. I'm pretty sure that means that's everything in that portion since we got the thing that was up there. Oh, I forgot to restock. Got another one. Now we need 3 to level up. Offers 10 of respite. Because if that's one of the problems that can occur is that, like this quest, experiment, live samples, you need to scan a Pikemander. I haven't come across a Pikemander yet. This is literally it for this area? Yeah, this is a dead end. All right, then. Well, that was interesting. Oh, hey, another orange goo. That's 9 down, 91 to go. More carbon. Yep, no, there's nothing else that direction. Yeah, kind of wish I was left-handed right now, because then I could actually scan this thing.
Terminate more than I do right now.
Ay, ay, ay. There it is. Oh my goodness. Just yeah. Not really invested in killing the rest of the bug booskas that were made. I just needed to go ahead and scan each stage of them. Wait, what?
Just in case killing the adults wasn't sadistic enough.
Egg-shaped birds come from egg-shaped eggs. I've been down here. Feel like I've been down there. Same time, I feel like I haven't been down there, which is making me question everything. I find it weird that the giant trees are not scannable. Have I been down here? Secret nearby. That's actually a new thing that... That looks suspicious, but it's not saying anything. That's actually interesting. I'm pretty sure that requires something we don't have yet, though. Again, not exactly super surprising. This, yes, that is a bottomless cliff. Oh, I've been hearing the meat vortex this entire time. Wow, I feel very paranoid suddenly. Silicon going into the void. Planix roots molten lava with the right upgrades. You can throw the lava at people and ruin their whole thing. Somehow less explosive than an actual human teenager. Okay. So when we get the upgrade, that'll allow us to actually, you know, use that to... Okay. More little droplets here and there. We've gotten virtually no aluminum from this portion of this outing. Why do they still look unique when...
You can craft an upgrade if you wanna.
That's not orange goo detector. That's pretty good. Alien alloy detector. Also pretty good, but kilt with fire, static panic. Rank two. Fast reload then. And I may as well do this because of the fact we have plenty of carbon and silicon. May cause death, paralysis, pneumonia, and depression. Are you desperate to escape the dismal drudgery of your daily grind, but can barely find the time to even stop and think about how bored you are? Do you feel tired of being a lame, predictable, and overwhelmingly dull person, but don't have the cash to do something for once in your sad, pathetic life? Have you ever dreamt of navigating the lush foliage of the Amazon, feeling the mists of Niagara on your face, or swimming amongst the vibrant colors of the Great Barrier Reef, only to remember that such wonders either burst into flames or sank into the ocean long, long ago? Funnily enough, I have done one of those three things. Let extra reality tours whisk you away by injecting your fantasy vacation straight into your brain. Enjoy perfect weather, visit impossible destinations, be an interesting person. The choice is yours. For a limited time, we're offering a 50% off our Platinum Friendship Package. Simulate actual friends and fully immerse yourself in the wild fantasy that people like you and want to be around you. That feels a bit too real. I mean, Ice Cavern, Sanctar's Frigid Embrace. We like weird. The Verdant Wilds of Zeal. October 2034. General Tweed's Chinese Chicken. Chinese Kitchen. Oh, that's actually funny. 555-555-55555. I can't tell what that picture is down there. Head outside the javelin.
Ambient temperature, 112 degrees. Biosigns, nominal.
Cartographer deployment hats. Cartographer calls this home. Or would, if they were sentient. Just notice the particle effects there. Wait, what? These are still around? Ooh, neat! We're finally up here! Point of that was, I have no idea. 50 silicon. Oh, there's an orange goop over here. Level up! And that was our 10th. Nothing. Where did that puffer bird come from? Just all of a sudden, puffer bird! Yeah, looks like that's all that was up here. I still don't know how that puffer bird got up there. The other problem is that, like, here, oh, hey, I killed it! I didn't know you could actually kill these things. Got him! This was where we found our first orange goo. There's a secret nearby. That one exploded into silk.
It's appeared and seems to really love shiny things.
Oh my goodness, this is complicated. Nope. Oh look, carbon. Now the problem is that it looks like the only way to make, okay, either there's a, an upgrade that lets you, like, hold a puffer bird. Yes! Hey, we got another orange goo. And 50 more carbon. I love exploring games like this, I really do. Oh, wait, what? This is scannable?
These remains are a hell of a lot older than anything else we found on this planet.
This enormous skeleton remains of an ancient, long-extinct species of mega quadrupeds. I would be so upset if that lacked collision. Then again, we found there are a bunch of things in this game that lack collision for like no reason. Or like areas that you can end up in that you shouldn't. Which absolutely terrifies me. Oh, it just hit me that that skull belongs to the spine of this beast. Oh my goodness, that thing is huge. And also, I finally used the bait for something. Yeah, I don't see how you're supposed to realistically get up there. I just don't. Owie. Fire, 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 fire. Surprising how many shots that takes. That was not even close. That getting that particular quest done is gonna be kind of difficult, I feel. Charging right along. No. Over, grab you. It's weird, these were called like the lesser enemies of whatever these were. When will we find the greater ones then? Excuse me. All right. Yes! That did not work. That's the path that we were down earlier. Hey, we got up here! Too bad we can't actually make any more progress without the axle. Hey, we got one of the four quests done because we managed to actually go ahead and complete one of the four experiments. Oh, you have to kill five ground creatures while they're airborne. Okay. That's easier than I thought it said. I know I can't jump all the way over there. Wait, I question. I don't even know how high 50 meters is considered in this game. So. Can I just go ahead, go up and around here? I sincerely doubt this is 50 meters, but doesn't hurt to try. Gotcha. No, that was nowhere near high enough. Oh, I can't exactly jump off that direction. Nope, still not far enough. Okay, I must need to find like a really high ledge to jump off of for that to actually work. I still don't know what a Pikemander is or where it is. What? Oh, that was just the dead body. Oh, here we can actually get a good look at what the skull actually looks like. Oh, and there's a cave beneath it. Oh, flight risk, 4 out of 5. Okay. Well, that didn't help me much. I just went in a big old circle. Since, yeah, that's the one that I found easily. Apparently there was the one that's on the other side. Why is there just this random red marker in the sky? Hitting L3 so many times actually is starting to hurt. I think this might be one of the hardest ones to get a puffer to actually go towards. Come on, follow me. Got it! Got another one, that's 12. No, it fell. to its doom. Died when it hit the ground, great. Well, okay, that doesn't work. Wonderful. What is with all of these, like, meows? I keep hearing. It is beyond strange. Turn back up here. Oh, hey, look, another egg nest. Oh, I just realized. Hey, hey, we did it. No. We did it again. No. Grab delicious, nutritious, technically food. I want to hit one more of these things whilst it's in the air. Nope, that didn't work either. That's our third one we've done! Got it! Tranquil crevasse of tranquility. These things are not scannable? Okay. Bam. And that was a hole in one. Secret nearby. Okay. I think I need to go back and get bait. Something that I surprisingly have not used very often. Wait, oh, it only grabbed me one. Oh, there's one right here, okay. What is that behind it? I don't think we've seen a white deposit yet. Gotcha. Now kick. What? Hole in one, baby. Little shop of horrors. Level up. Look at how high our health is compared to when we started. Look at it. Secret nearby. Yeah, yeah, we know. Another one in my tum. Thank you. That one was easy. Also, how do you have names for these things if you've never seen them before? Oh, hey, yet another one. That's 15 already. Oh, look, another nest. Oh, press Y while the weapon is fully reloaded to initiate. Wow, we're still pretty dang far. Oh, we're over here! Okay, I didn't expect that. That's actually really interesting. I did not expect to be over here at this point. Nope, we need to... not be on these platforms, okay. Hello, Mr. Pomegranate Plants. How are you useful for me right now? Defense meets offense meets spikes meets your face. Try to shoot its exposed heart when it opens its cell. Ouch, ouch, ouch. Okay, the first successful.
This meteor arrived a few years before we did.
No, that did nothing. Apparently, that meteor's apparently super recent. And look at, like, all of these islands that are off in the distance, and this just happens to be the one we landed on. Start the alien teleport network. 2 out of 20. Thank you. Wow, you guys open fast. Got him, finally! Some creatures can only be hurt by a melee takedown, which might involve sneaking around.
These branches have latched onto a nearby host creature in order to survive. Aww, it's shy.
Sproutlock. Look, Bulletproof suffers from severe social anxiety. Recommended tactics, stealth therapy. Take down! Hopefully there isn't a quest that requires me to get a live sample of one of those. Some? Where's the other one? I think I'm standing in the exact worst spot to try and attack that thing. Wasn't there a life plant like right around here? Yes, there was. Hallelujah. Yeah, I'm like, oh my goodness. Ouch. Oh, looks like we're actually gonna need to. Boom! Chaka-laka-laka. Oh, that was an aluminum vein. Okay! Oh, hey, look. More silicon. That color makes me think it's iron, though. More carbon, heal up. And another one, which means we've leveled up yet again. Oh, there's just carbon here. I'm betting that they made those scannable after you've acquired them because of... Otherwise, I think it'd be... possible to... complete the game, not have scanned them, and not be able to get 100% because if you can't scan one if you've already acquired it.
The plasma's in the next room. The sonar suggests it's locked inside some sort of geode.
Locked inside a geode. And another one! That's 17! Dang it. Got it. Hallelujah. Proton tether sign. The crystal housed in this shrine's basin is very powerful. Grab a sample and use it to create a proton tether. I do love how the scan just like makes everything go into that grid line structure. Did that open up? Because I swear we've been here before. Yeah, because of... Yeah, they're... What? Wait, there's another one of those creature skulls here. But that one isn't scannable. Well, that was easy, but that was just really dumb.
I discovered.
Have we even seen sock fruit yet? 150 silicon for the grapple. Okay.
Proton tether. Perfect for scaling sheer cliffs and clambering into weird, arbitrarily floating cubes. The cartographers can now plot a path from your location to the required upgrade ingredient. Go get it. Or don't. Your choice. But your compass has been updated.
Triple thrusters. That'll be useful. Ah, that's our next quest. Yeah. Greet Monocorp First Galactic Bank of Commerce. Greetings, client number 329453045. We here at Monocorp First Galactic Bank of Commerce, proud member of the Globoverse family of corporation and financial subsidiaries, are delighted to share with you a wonderful development in your financial status. As of today, your checking account balance is now $492,237. While this level of debt may seem substantial, with your recent promotion to Intergalactic Explorer combined with its accompanying Does CHEQUING mean basically like your debt account? Combined with its accompanying 2% bump in annual salary, we can now project that you will likely be free and clear of debt in as little as 47 years. Projection represents a significant step down from your previous projection of 51 years and puts you well above average in terms of debt elimination among the general population. From careful review of these recent developments, the decision has been made to downgrade the status of your debt from crippling to deeply debilitating. Congratulations and keep up the good work. Financial freedom is merely a half century away. Oh my goodness, that is so, so stupid. Collect all of the cards. Apparently, we were not supposed to be able to get this one so early, it looks like. Though, in all honesty, these three look really intimidating. It's either this, or this is the creature we're actually looking for. There's this giant thing.
Ambient temperature 92 degrees. Vital signs nominal.
92. Grappling. Oh, this has to be the area where we go in. important? Oh, jeez. Here. Gotcha. Okay. Oh, there's literally nothing up there.
Nearby source of fuel that might help us with our get out of here eventually problem. If you can scan it and tag it, one of the cartographers can lug it back to the ship for you. Oh, good. We're not going to be stranded on this hell planet after all. You found what looks like to be a fuel cell from somewhere inside the tower. No idea how it got here exactly, but it's a perfect fuel source for the Javelin. I'll dispatch a cartographer to extract it.
Alrighty, Rooney. Oh my goodness, I do not know if... Oh, hey. Apparently I completed... Okay. Yeah, that was a lot of health. How are you supposed to? Okay, that's not helpful.
The blobby part seems impervious to damage, but there's definitely something trapped inside.
What? What do you mean I can't get this? the fuck? Well, I found something incredibly weird that I don't know how to deal with. I'm betting anything that contains an alien alloy. Oh, those are where the... Okay, I feel a little bit more dumb now. Not less dumb, you feel more dumb? Holy cow, I cannot believe I made that. This feels so incredibly scary. Oh, thank goodness those are automatic. If they weren't, I feel like a vast majority of people who would get to that point would just automatically be yeeted into the abyss and lose all the stuff they had on them at the time. Oh, there it is. That's you? You? Where am I? Okay, we're only down here. That's not that bad. Thought we were gonna end up way lower down. I was hoping that it wouldn't be a getting over it kind of scenario. The thing is that, like, in Metroid games, when you have the grapple beam is not... Oh, great. You mean that was a lie? Thanks a lot, game. Thanks a lot. Ugh. dump. Jump over. Jump over. Jump back. Somehow it says I'm only like 47 meters from my destination. Oh no, is that really the point it wants me to grab onto next? Oh my goodness, I barely made that. Voltivore pimple. Some people actually enjoy watching pimples pop. Those people are weirdos. Look, aluminum vein. Weird, this one only has two. Oops. Alien alloy, 3 out of 32. Gotcha. Whack. Oh, I'm now further away from where I was. Wait, I just went into a big old loop. Go over here. Jump back.
Fascinating. The seeds you just picked up appear to belong to the limpet-like plants we saw earlier. they grow on.
All the way up here. Oh, great. Grapple. 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 Gotcha. Okay. Oh boy. Hallelujah. An uncharacteristic display of pufferboard ingenuity could likely be breached with heavy explosives. Puffs do even more than other pufferboards. It wasn't very good, but you did your best.
So, how was nothingness?
Oh, and I need... Derp. There we go. Okay. I think I'm actually going to end things. Well, wait. After I set the death counter properly. Thank you. I'm going to end things here for now. Because of... I've been streaming for 4 hours. I'm kind of tired. Like, comment, and subscribe if you enjoy my work. And please do share my content and join the Discord. It really does help me out. Follow me here on Twitch and on Facebook. And always come aboard the Starship. LP, Renew After Hero, Villain, or NPC. I hope